Autism is really a collection of different diseases. There are many genetic causes of autism. In fact, the more we look, the more causes there are. The question is, do they converge? Do they have a behavioral convergence? So there are certain aspects of behavior that autistic children and adults have. But is there a biological convergence? Well, in this paper, we examined brains of children and adolescents with autism and compare them to controls and found out that indeed there is a difference. From early childhood into adolescence, synapses that are the ways that neurons communicate with each other are pruned. In other words, you start off when at the age of, say, 3 with about twice the density of synapses that you have at the age of about 15. But this doesn't occur in the people with autism. They don't have this synaptic pruning. The next question is why? So we then found that there is a process of self-eating by the cell itself, where the, in this case, the neuron says, time to get rid of a synapse. I'm going to eat the synapse. The process is called autophagy, which literally means eat yourself. But people with autism, this process of self-eating or autophagy is not occurring, and you're not getting the normal decline in the synapse. Finally, you would say, can you use this for treatment? We hope that it can. And the reason we have some optimism about this is because we can replicate what happens with this problem in synaptic pruning in mice. We found that if you can chemically, using a drug, increase the activity of autophagy, now you can regain normal synaptic pruning. Now, if we can go back to humans, either using this drug, which is not a perfect drug, we need better ones that would do similar things. Even after a child is diagnosed with autism, it's not too late. While there's an extraordinary amount of work to be done in the future, we hope that this has given us some insight that this condition might actually be treatable even after diagnosis.